goed even mee in je mam?
Ja.
Oh, thanks, kijk meestal. Zo, what time did your fancy fella get off last night then?
Oh, it's quite late actually, ages after you and my mum had gone to bed.
Oh. Things getting serious between you then?
Yeah.
So you're really into him?
Yeah, he's dead nice.
All right. So on a scale of 1 to 10, how would you rate him?
Oh, about 3.
That all?
Only joking, about 9.5 really.
Mm. Must be love then, eh?
So, do you think we make a nice couple?
Yeah, I suppose so, but...
But what?
Well, look, love, don't take this the wrong way, but... Well, he's not exactly the sort of fella you'd take to the match, is he?
What exactly do you mean by that?
Well, you know, he's an hairdresser, isn't he? You know what they can be like.
No, I don't, actually. All I know is you seem to think that if you don't drink 10 pints in a night and have a season ticket for Everton, it somehow makes you less of a man. I'm going to get dressed.
So I'm not the kind of fella you can take the night, and I like that cup of that.
Take my notice of him.
Oh, don't worry, I will.
Better go before they see you.
Oh, I didn't know you were so old-fashioned.
Oh, I am, actually.
Oh, just think, Lindsay, if we did live together, we wouldn't have to put up with all this palaver, would we? Oh, God, look at the state of me head. I can't go out looking like
you. You can't forget about your hair. Come on.
Going where?
To school.
It's half term.
We've got rehearsals for the play.
What play?
I told you, for November the 5th.
Oh, yes. Yeah, OK. But listen, be sure to be back for when your mum arrives, won't you?
Yeah, I'll do. See you later.
Yeah, bye.
Bye, Dan. When's Belle coming?
About 3, I think.
Oh, well, I'll make myself scarce then. I think you've already polished that 5 times this morning.
Yes, well, I don't want Belle thinking that I'm letting this place go to pot.
Stop worrying. I'm sure it'll all be fine.
How can it be fine? Dan might decide he wants to go and live with his mother.
Come on. Stop torturing yourself with all this. You don't even know what Danny's decided yet.
Yeah. Well, maybe I'm just preparing myself for the worst. What else can I do?
Dad, any chance of a cuppa?
No, there isn't.
Oh, go on, don't be tight.
I'm not being tight. Come here, you. Just have a look what Bing has done because of you. He's labelled everything.
What's he done that for?
Probably because he's sick and tired of you sneaking in here and helping yourself to stuff that isn't yours. And quite frankly, Michael, so am I.
Well, that's very nice, isn't it? I'm homeless, don't forget.
Yeah, and so will I be if you don't get yourself shifted. It's about time you got yourself up from your backside, you know, and found yourself somewhere else to live.
Well, what am I supposed to do?
Michael, you can sell the big issue for all I care, son. I just want you out of here. Otherwise, we'll both end up on the street.
What are you doing?
Writing a list. All of the reasons that make Jackie Dixon a perfect surrogate mother.
Susanna, please, will you just listen to me? What makes you think that a successful young businesswoman like Jackie Dixon would ever consider something like this?
Well, why are you so convinced that she wouldn't?
What are you going to do when she says no? Ask Katie Rogers, Rachel Jordash?
I'm just being silly.
I'm being silly?
We've known Jackie a long time. It was even us she came to see when she wanted advice and starting up her business.
So what?
Oh, Max, please, try to be a little more open-minded. Apart from not being family, Jackie matches all of the qualities that made Lisa so perfect in the first place. Look, she's independent. Not in a relationship, she's business-minded. She doesn't want a child of her own.
Look, well, it's all very well listing all these pluses, but what about all the minuses? The fact that she's the daughter of our bigoted next-door neighbour. The fact that that family made my life hell for the first couple of years of living round here. The fact that she runs a bar full of junkies.
Oh, Max, you can't blame Jackie for that.
I am warning you not to go anywhere near Jackie Dixon.
Is that an order?
I don't want you to risk making a fool of yourself.
Very well. If I'm banned from speaking to her, you can. I'm sure you'll be a lot more tactful than me. In fact, you can pop round later, test the water.
I will do no such thing.
Why not?
Because I think it's the most ridiculous idea I've ever heard.
It's your choice, Max. Either you speak to her or I do, because I'll tell you this. I'm not going to let this go until we've at least tried.
Any sign of the other fella yet?
Oh, he'll be in. It's payday, isn't it? I can't believe I've got to hand over a grand to him.
How much?
Oops. Someone's got big ears.
When did that go up?
Last week.
Just tell him where to go, you know.
Oh, that's a good idea. I'll try that when he comes in.
I just don't know where it's all gonna end. Just like he's took over the place.
Yeah, well, I don't want you worrying. The last thing you need is any stress. Why don't you and Bingo down the Legion or something later, try and take your mind off all this for a bit?
Just wish it were that simple. Anyway, I'm not really in Bing's good books at the moment, due to this fella here.
Jack, what's the score here?
What do you mean?
Well, I came in here last night for a quiet pint after work, and the bouncer stopped me from coming in because I had a pair of jeans on them. Is that your idea or what?
Kind of, yeah. We're just trying to smarten up the image of the place.
Well, what about all your regulars?
Oh, look, Simba, don't give me a hard time. I've got enough on my plate at the moment.
Oh, I'm sorry to bother you. Well, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll take my custom elsewhere in future, eh?
Oh, come on, Sim, there's no need for
that. No, hang on, Ron, just a minute. And I'll pass the word around. I'll tell everyone that the likes of me are not good enough for you anymore.
Sim, it's not like that, honestly, man. Here we go.
Hello. Calm down now, have we?
I'll only calm down when you're out of this place for good.
You're the one that signed the contract, Ron.
I suppose you've come for your money.
Yeah, but I'll get it later. There's no rush. I'm going to be here for a while. I've arranged to meet some friends for business. I thought you'd appreciate the extra custom. What am I usual when you're ready?
Dad, could you see to him?
Jackie, what time's it?
Don't just come barging in here without knocking.
I'm sorry, I just wanted to know what time the delivery.
Yeah, well, can you just leave me alone, please, because I'm up to my eyes. What?
Have I picked a bad time?
Oh, I'm sorry, Max. I thought you were all right.
No, it's just that he told me that you were in here.
Yeah, come in. What can I do for you?
Yeah. It's a bit awkward, actually. The thing is, I don't know where to start. I'm worried about Susanna. She hasn't been the same since we lost our children. Now she's had this idea. It's it's a ridiculous idea, but I thought I should warn you just in case she approached you herself.
What's wrong?
All right, it's nothing. I'll be okay in a minute.
Oh, come on, people don't just burst into tears for no reason at all. What's upset you?
I've just got myself into a terrible mess with this place.
In what way?
Just money stuff. I'm having a nightmare.
Oh, I thought you were doing incredibly well.
Well, I was. It's complicated. I've got myself involved in something. I don't think I'm ever going to be able to get out of it.
Oh, surely things aren't that bad.
I've nearly killed myself trying to get this place off the ground. The way things are going now, I could end up losing it all.
Where's Dan?
He's rehearsing the school play. He said he'd be back by now.
Oh, nice. Didn't think they'd be your colour.
Yes, it's very amusing. They're,
Eleanor's, I know. Dan told me she'd moved in.
Would you like a drink?
Oh, no, thanks. So, where is Eleanor?
She's at work.
Keeping out of my way?
No, she's at work.
And how does Dan feel about Eleanor moving in?
Oh, they get on very well together.
Must be quite awkward for him, though, the complete stranger hanging around the house.
How's Patrick?
There you go, son. A lot tidier for you now, eh? Try and come and see it again next week. If I've got the time. Things are a bit manic at the moment, you know. What with the new baby, the college work and all that.
All right, Jimmy. Don't tell me a grave robber now.
Barry. What are you doing here?
Who is he, anyway? Oh, I haven't seen him for ages. Keith Dawson. Same age as me.
What happened to him?
Heart attack.
Terrible, isn't it? Another young life wasted. You must be gutted.
Well, no, I'm not. To be honest with you, Jimmy, I couldn't stand him.
You what?
You know me, Jimmy. I'm not a hypocrite. You couldn't trust him as far as you could throw him. He was only interested in you if you had a few bob. In fact, he still owes me 500 quid. Still, he can keep it. I know whose shoes I'd rather be in.
So how come you'd come to his funeral if you couldn't stand him?
Well, I was more close to his missus, if you know what I mean. So she asked me to come. Couldn't really say no, could I?
Must like her a lot to come all the way from America for this.
I'm not living in America anymore. Came back about a year ago.
Oh, mate. So where are you now, Nick?
Down south.
So what are you doing? You getting off for a bevy with this lot or what?
No, I think I'll give it a miss. It's all family and that, isn't it? I'll call around and see Paula later when it's all quiet and down.
Do you fancy coming for a drink with me? And catch up and that, like?
I don't think so, Jim.
Oh, come on, take you to the parade. It's all completely different now, you know. You wouldn't recognise it.
I don't know about that.
Come on, Barry. One pint's not going to do you any harm, is it? Eh? Well, Ruth's gone, you know. Some trendy wine bar now with balconies and all sorts.
You what?
Yeah, painted up in all these trendy colours. Enough to give you a migraine. You'd be amazed.
Come on then, Jimmy. Amaze me. Here you go. Dark out now, you know. Don't you think they'll be getting worried?
Yeah, so what? Let them worry.
Did you hear about the dyslexic raver? Got off his face on an F.
It's not very PC, is it?
Well, so much for trying to cheer you up.
A joke must be older than David Crosby.
Don't suppose you're in the mood for listening to jokes, are you?
No, not really. I just don't know what I'm going to do.
Hard choice, eh?
Yeah.
Well, it's not your fault, is it? I mean, they're the ones who are getting divorced. And whichever one you don't choose is only going to be upset because, well, they love you so much.
Don't make it any easier for me, though. I'm the one who's going to have to go back there and face them, tell them who's won.
Well, it's not about winning, is it?
this to them.
You, a teacher. You're joking, aren't you? I'm telling you. I'm in college nearly every day. Jimmy, are you sure you're not back on the smack or something?
I left all that behind years ago.
God, this place has changed, hasn't it? What's happened to the tunnel? What about the trading post?
It closed down months ago, there. Dixon reckons that the new garage put him out of business. Sells everything. Come on, let's get a bevy.
Yeah.
No jeans, mate.
You?
No jeans.
Need it. Barry. This blinger to pump me in because I've got jeans on. Do you remember when I used to be on the door here?
How could I forget?
Well, I'm going to go home and get changed. Listen, get the air in, will you? Mine's a locker.
Yeah, all right. See you later.
Hello, stranger. What are you doing around here? Don't you remember me, Jackie Dixon?
Oh, God, you changed. What's happened to all your hair?
Oh, I had it chopped off ages ago. So what are you doing around here? I thought you lived in America now.
Came back for a mate's funeral.
Oh, so what are you up to?
Hey, this and that, you know.
Jackie, my friends have waited long enough for the meals. Could you sort it out, please?
Yes, I will now.
Yeah, thank you.
Is that the boss? A bit of an arc, isn't he?
No, he isn't the boss. I am.
Oh, why?
Yeah, I'm following your footsteps. And I've got the salon next door.
What's happened? Have you won the lottery or something?
No, I'm just a very good businesswoman.
Any chance of their meals, Jackie?
Give me a chance, will you? I'm doing it now.
Thank you.
Well, if you're the boss, how come he's giving the orders?
Don't ask.
Local customer?
I wish. No, between me and you, he just came in here the other week. He's taking over the door.
Oh, I see.
There was nothing I could do. He just marched in here and started taking over. It's been a nightmare.
What's his name?
Callum. Callum Finnegan. Why, do you know him?
No. No, I've never heard of him.
Did you have to put up with all this sort of crap when you were running Lalouth?
You're joking, aren't
you? I just thought you might be able to offer me some advice. Anyway, better go and chase up their food before he has another kick-off. Are you staying around for a bit?
Yeah, go have a drink, aren't
you? Oh, nice to see you anyway.
Yeah, see ya.
See ya. Back ages ago.
Just rushed off her feet at the restaurant. I mean, Diane, she's got flu.
Well?
Well, what? Well,
did you go and see Jackie?
Yes.
And?
Well...
You didn't ask her, did you?
I couldn't.
Oh, it's typical, Max. You're always chickening out.
Hang on. I was about to broach the subject when all of a sudden, out of the blue, she burst into tears.
Well, why?
Well, I'm not really sure, but it seems as if she's got herself into some kind of problem with the bar. She said that she's got big money worries.
Well, I thought she was doing incredibly well.
Yeah, so did I, but it seems her little business empire isn't moving as swiftly as it might be.
Did she say what the problem was?
No, she was rather vague, but she did say that she might end up losing her business.
Perfect.
Hmm?
Do I have to spell it out? You asked me this morning why a successful businesswoman like Jackie Dixon would have a surrogate baby for us. Well, there's the answer. Staring us in the face, it's simple. She needs the cash.
You did tell him what time I was coming?
Yes, of course.
Well, maybe he just can't face us. I can't say I'd blame him. Dan, where were you? We were worried about you.
What kept you so long?
I just needed some time to think. Look, if you need more time to make a decision, we neither of us want to pressurize you.
No, I agree. Neither of us want to force you into anything.
No, it's all right. I've made up my mind. I just think it's really bad that we can't sort this out together. But I know who I want to live with.
Do you know anything about him, Nick?
No, not really. I know he's got a security firm. He's got the door on this place.
I don't like the look of him.
Wouldn't have happened in your day, eh, boss? You'd have seen him off.
No, well, I don't suppose Jackie Dixon's got much of a chance, has she?
Hi, Dad.
Hello, Kurt. What are you doing here?
I said I'd meet Peter for a drink after work.
Remember Barry, don't you? Barry Grant.
Hiya. How are you?
All the better for seeing you.
And I can't believe how much everyone's changed around here.
So, what are you doing around here?
Oh, just passing through, you know.
Sounds mysterious.
Yeah, well, that's me. Where do you get your looks from? Obviously, it's not from your aunt, fella.
Oh, thank you. Oh, sorry, Emily, babe. I thought I'd never get out of that place. Excuse me if I stink a lacquer on old age pensions.
Peter, this is Barry Grant, an old mate of my dad's.
Hiya, Barry, nice to meet you. Oh, and God, he's got a strong handshake, hasn't he? I'm only messing, mate. Right, what can I get everyone to drink?
You can get me a pint of lager.
Yeah, well, I'm driving, all right. What about you, my sweet dad?
Oh, you're feeling generous?
I've got £3.50 and it's got to go. Who's he?
Ah, Lindsay's new fella. Works in the hairdresser's next door.
What's she doing with him?
Having a good time, so keep your hands to yourself.
I want you both to promise you won't make me feel bad about who I choose.
No, of course we won't.
Because, you know, this hasn't been easy for me. Look, we know that. Oh, Mom. I'm sorry. I've decided to stay here. Live with Dad.
Well, apparently it's absolutely gorgeous out there. Place up from a wamp video. Donna next door, who works in the salon, her cousin went out there backpacking. And according to her, you can be in the sea up to your waist and still see your feet. Which is all very well if you're not absolutely petrified of jellyfish like me. And I bet they've got some really exotic jellyfish out in Bali, haven't they? Oh, God, listen to me, boring the leg off everybody. I haven't stopped ranting on about Bali since I got here, have I? You'd have to excuse me, I'm always like this.
So when do you go?
A week Friday. Don't know how I'm going to manage it all them hours on the plane. And there's never enough leg room, is there?
So you'll be all on your lonesome then, eh?
Yeah.
So, what are your plans then, boss? Getting up for a bevy with that fella's widow? Just for this wee drink, eh?
Great! That is enough! Get off! I want you out of here! Get off now! Get off!
Aye, aye!
Sorry about that, mate.
You will be if it happens again.
You what?
You heard?
And who are you?
I'm a customer.
Yeah, and that was an accident.
Yeah, well, like I said, don't let it happen again. I mightn't be as understanding next time, all right?
Was your problem, Paul?
Barry, come on, we don't need trouble.
I'd take that as a warning if I was you.
Does one refill?
Yes, he is, Jack. And one for Peter, is it?
Yeah.
I thought you were getting off. Well, I thought I might stick around for a bit, you know. It's nothing I can't keep till tomorrow.
Well, after all that testosterone flying around Bar Brookie, Chandler's in touch with his feminine side in Friends. Friday comedy is next.
Are you sure you don't want anything to eat? I mean, you didn't have any breakfast.
Oh, no, honestly, Max, I couldn't. I've got no appetite whatsoever.
Don't build your hopes up too high.
But why? Now we know how desperately she needs the money. Jackie Dixon would be the perfect surrogate mum.
Yes, well, that may be right, but Jackie might not see it that way.
Well, there's only one way to find out. And that's to ask her.
Some
light rain may fall tonight on western coastal areas, particularly on the west of Scotland.
Oh, come with me. You said you would.
Look, I can't just drop everything because you want to go training every 2 minutes. I've got a business to run.
But it's no good on my own. I mean, I need you to time me.
Look, I'll get the bike out later, all right? But I'm not doing it now because I'm too busy. Now, isn't this something you can be doing by yourself?
Hey, do as you told you.
Hello, stranger.
All right.
Look, get off. I'll see you later on, all right?
But I'm coming back around the shop.
Yeah. Long time no see. What are you doing around here?
Looks like you got your hands full there.
Yeah, it's my bird's son. Well, I heard you were back. Well, I never believed it. Didn't think I'd see you around here again.
Yeah, well, you know what it's like with Liverpool. Wherever you end up, you'd always end up coming back, don't you?
Yeah.
Is this your gaff?
Yep, my own little empire. I suppose I could interest you in a kettle or a cooker, could I?
Nah, you're all right. So how's business?
Well, it's better than window cleaning. I'm on my way up, mate. And you don't look as if you've been going without. Don't tell me crime does pay.
Hey, listen, I'm a respectable businessman. Oh. I even get invited to all the local charity dues.
All right. Well, if you want to make a donation to this place, feel free.
Oh, I don't think so. Mind you, it looks as if you're doing all right. Everyone seems to be doing all right. Have you seen anything of Terry?
Terry? No, he got off a while back. He had some trouble with his alpha. I don't suppose you've heard anything.
No. I haven't been in touch with anyone, not even my own family. Thought to keep my head down for a bit. You know how it is.
Yeah, I suppose so.
Anyway, since when have they needed bouncers at Dicko's bar?
Yeah, that's just a recent thing, that. I don't know what's going on there.
Thanks. Hello, stranger. How are you?
Hello, thanks. How are you?
Oh, not bad. We just got back.
Yeah, I thought I'd drop these off, catch up on the gas, and I'm going to go and show my face and work.
Are you crawling? You're not due until tomorrow.
Yeah, I'm here to get Nellie's good books, will it? So how's things been here?
That Finnegan's still around, bleeding me dry.
Oh, God.
Yeah, anyway, I'll fill you in on that later. I want to try and forget about it for 5 minutes. So, how's Five Alive?
Five Alive can drop dead for all I care.
Why, what happened?
Oh, Jackie, it was terrible. There was nothing but arguments and backstabbing. They get on my nerves, a lot of them. You know, if it wasn't about money, it was about who's pinched whose hair gel or eyeliner. That was just the fellas. The girls were even worse. I've just had enough of it all.
Oh, Casey, what are you going to do? You spent all this time training to be a dancer. You're not going to split up with them, are you?
Well, I don't know. I just feel like it's all a waste of time.
Yeah, well, it seems like everything's just gone mad round here.
Oh, what do you mean?
Well, you're never going to guess who split up. Rachel and Christian.
Oh, yeah, you liar.
Honest to God, Casey, I'm not going to lie about something as serious as that, am I?
Was Rachel all right?
Well, I think so. She just feels dead embarrassed about it all. You know, pretending she was happy when she wasn't.
Poor thing. When did all this happen?
Well, listen, it's a long story. I'll get us 2 coffees and tell you all about it. You won't believe what went on. It was terrible.
Like to think I'm coping. Oh, time moves on so quickly. Before we know it, it'll be Christmas again. I'm really not looking forward to that at all.
No, I don't suppose you are.
But who knows what might happen before then?
Oh, Mrs. Farnham, Dave, I've just seen something very peculiar going on between the trees at the back of the woods.
Why, what did you see?
Well, I was minding my own business, just cleaning the windows, and I looked down. Then he was there, and then he wasn't, and then he was there again. I would like to think what he was doing. Oh, hey, you don't think it's anything to do with Barry Grant, do you?
Barry? Why?
Well, I saw him earlier on the parade. And it's a bit of a coincidence, isn't it? Him turning up, and then there's all kinds of strange people lurking around.
Julian, I don't think you should rush to conclusions.
I think it would be best if I call the police.
No, calm down, both of you. In the woods, you said, Julian?
Yeah.
Right, Susanna, if you wouldn't mind. I'll go and check this out.
Just a minute, David. Do you think this is wise? I think it would be safer if I call the police.
Not at all. I'm sure it's something I can deal with.
Oh, I'd better come with you, Jay. Oh, we stand a better chance if there's 2 of us.
Well, all right then, but you make sure that you stay well behind me.
You know, it isn't until you nearly lose something precious that you realise how lucky you are.
I take it you mean Van.
I know it must have been awful for Belle, but I'm so happy that Dan chose to live with me. I mean, it's just the little things, you know, like dropping him off at school, having dinner together, hearing his key in the door when he comes home. I'm sure it all sounds very silly.
Oh, not at all. I'm really pleased for you.
And, you know, it won't alter anything between us. Things will carry on exactly as they were.
You don't need to keep reassuring me. I'm fine. Well, as long as you don't expect me to play mother.
You'll be in trouble if you do. It's a long time since Dan needed mothering.
Suits me fine. I'm sorry, I've got to get back to the office.
All right. Are you on your own again today?
Yes, and I made a bit of a blunder.
Why?
Well, in a moment of madness, I booked myself in the salon this afternoon for a complete beauty makeover. Hair, nails, skin, the lot. Like a completely new image.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah, well, it sounded good to me until I realised that Katie's not back until tomorrow, so there'll be nobody to mind the office. So I suppose I better cancel.
Well, you can stay out a bit longer, can't you? The answer phone's on.
Yeah, but...
Go on, pamper yourself. Hello? Yes. Yes, she's here. It's Katie for you.
Oh, thanks. Hi. Oh, brilliant. I'll be there in 5 minutes. Thanks. Bye. Problem solved. She came back early.
Perfect timing. One afternoon of pampering coming up.
See you. Bye.
Hiya, love.
Hi, Mr. Dixon.
You're wasted doing that, you know.
Oh, tell me about it.
Actually, I could help you out.
Go on. You're going to make me an offer I can't refuse. What is it? A job for a cleaner in the bar?
No, nothing like that. But it is something that'll do a lot more justice to your talents. I've got a gig for you if you want it.
Where is it? Down at the Legion?
No, no, it's Sister Club. Nothing tacky, though, nothing tacky. They rang me this morning and asked me to fix up somebody for them. So naturally I thought of you. What do you think?
Is it a nice club?
Oh, yeah, yeah. I've heard it gets chock-a-block and apparently lots of agents get in there. Now, look, it's tomorrow night, 1 half-hour spot, £80 cash in hand.
I really think you should have brought that spade, Shh, eh?
Julia. I'm trying to listen for footsteps.
What do you think we're going to find?
Absolute silence, Julia, please.
Oh, my God! What's that?
I don't know yet.
Do you think we should go back?
Certainly not. I'm very curious to find out exactly what is there.
Well, you know what they say, Dave. Curiosity killed the cat.
Julia, don't worry. In safe hands. I've done all this before. Now listen, I'm going to make a run for those bushes. When I get there, I shall raise my right hand and I want you to follow as fast as you can. Is that clear?
Oh, my God! Hang on, Dave. Why can't we both go together?
Because we're less of a target if we move apart singly.
Yeah, but we'll be more of a target if he gets us on our own.
All right. Now, when I say the word run, I want you to run, OK?
OK, Dave.
Come on, we know you're in there.
Gotcha.
All right, Lindsay, is your dad?
Not unless he's hiding in my pocket now.
I thought he might be round the back. I thought I saw him when I came round before, you know.
Yeah, I saw you.
Oh, I? Spying on me, eh?
No. Did you want something?
Well, I didn't answer that.
Oh, hi, love. What can I get you?
Fish and chips twice, please.
Salt and vinegar.
Thanks, yes.
Right, better be getting off then, Lindsay. Meeting the mate tonight.
Right, I'll see you then.
Yeah. See you when I see you.
My word, a bivouac. And splendidly put together.
You shouldn't be messing about in these woods. You could have given someone a heart attack.
I was only doing my army training. And anyway, what's it got to do with you?
Oh, you'd be so cheeky.
Don't forget, Timothy. Mrs. Brogan had you under surveillance, and had she been the enemy, you would have been well and truly spotted.
Ah, yeah. But if I'd been the enemy, you two would have been dead meat. I mean, he's come right to me.
Yes,
you
but...
should be telling him off, not encouraging him. And anyway, I don't know what you're listening to him for. So much for your safe hands. You could have got us both killed. And here, you can take that back yourself.
All right, love. Have you made your mind up yet?
Well, if the offer's still open, I wouldn't mind doing that cake tomorrow night.
Brilliant. I'll tell you what, love, you won't regret it. Excuse me.
There you go. Hiya, Max.
Hi.
Listen, the other night, I'm sorry for blubbering all over you.
Oh, it's okay.
I think it just needs the shoulders to cry on. But I feel it right, Divi, now. I shouldn't let things get on top of me.
Don't mention it.
Okay, then. So what can I get you?
Actually, I wanted a word with you.
On a boat?
Well, it's, I suppose you could call it a business proposition, one which would be worthwhile you considering.
Oh, right. Well, in that case, you'd better go into the office.
No, not here. I mean, later. With Susanna, back at the house.
Oh, okay then. Well, I'll call around later.
All right. Great. Right, well, I'll tell Susanna. Bye.
See ya.
Hi. It's only me.
Hi.
Is Dan in?
He won't be joining us. He's left a note saying he's having tea with his friend Michael. I take it you know who he means.
Yeah. Yeah, he's a friend from school. Mmm. Something smells good. I'm starving.
I'm afraid I can't take any credit for it. It's only a takeaway. Well, what do you think of my new image?
Show me the photos, Mr. Crosby.
Not at all, Timothy. My pleasure. Any time you want to talk about matters military, you're very welcome.
Oh, great. Thanks. It's been really interesting.
Here he is, Shannon.
All right, Tim. You're coming out?
All right, Shannon. I'm coming now.
I didn't know you were over here. What's up?
Nothing's up.
Timothy and I have been having a chat about the army. He now knows all the ranks of the personnel.
Come here, Jas. Thanks again, Mr. Crosby.
See you soon.
What are you with that old get for?
Mr. Crosby? Oh, nice, dead sand. Been talking to me about the army and that.
Don't know about the army making a man out of you. Sounds to me like it's saying you're soft.
Hey, Cheek, what's all this about making me into a man? I'm already a man. I'll prove it if you want.
I'll take your word for it.
Hey, that's how you doing, dude? Having okay? Yeah. Hi, this is the boss, then, is he?
Yeah, go straight through.
Considering you were supposed to be starving, you've hardly touched your meal. Didn't you really like it?
It's just a bit rich, that's all. I think I've got a spot of indigestion.
Ollie, you've hardly looked at me. If I've done something to upset you, I mean, at least tell me what it is so we can start to sort it out.
Sorry.
Do you want to talk about it?
No. No, not really. I've got a bit of a headache. I think I'll go in next door and relax with the paper.
What's the matter with you, Robbie? You're having a big, white wedding. Registry office? Don't even talk about registry offices. Your mum won't have that. Can you imagine Ari letting him get married without any fuss?
You're joking, aren't you? She's had that big flash out ready for donkey's years.
Not to mention the bag and the shoes. You've got no chance, mate.
We'll see about that.
He's a good kid.
Yeah, I remember when you used to bring him down to snooker all. He was only a puny little thing then, wasn't he?
Yeah, not anymore. And he's not stupid. He can handle himself. He's doing all right.
Yeah, I'm glad. You look as if you're doing all right as well.
Yeah. And how about you? How are you doing? I take it this isn't just social cuckoo.
I'm doing fine. I'm just a bit curious about a couple of fellas who are hanging around an old haunt of mine.
Oh, yeah?
You haven't heard of a fella called Finnegan, have you? Callum Finnegan.
Yeah, I've heard of him. Been around here for about 10 years, hasn't he? Bit of a head case.
Well, to be honest with you, I don't know that much about him, Rob.
Oh, I know all about him. His name seems to pop up regularly, and not for good reasons either. He's a bit of an extortion merchant. I can tell you all about him.
What if she laughs in our faces?
Well, why should she laugh at us? It's a serious proposition. There's nothing funny about it.
You know what I mean.
Mac, it's a brilliant idea, and from Jackie's point of view, it's good business sense. I mean, £15,000 for 9 months' work. We get all the hard part, bringing the child up. And anyway, it's not as if she has to sleep with you to do it.
Well, if that was involved with the deal, then Jackie Dixon would have to pay me.
Right. I'll get it. This is it.
Ah, David, hi. How can I help you?
I'm Max.
Thank you. I'm sorry to bother you both, but I seem to run out of bread. You couldn't spare me a few slices, could you?
Yes, of course.
It seems that young Michael Dixon doesn't appreciate the principle of pay your way. Treats my stores as if they were a free-for-all.
There you go.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Splendid. Oh, have you heard about Barry Grant turning up?
He's here in Liverpool.
Julia mentioned it this morning.
I wonder what's brought him back.
I have no idea.
Well, whatever it is, we're going to find out sooner or later. Aren't we, Max?
Yes, of course we will, yes. Well, must get on. I hope that's enough for you there, David.
Oh, yes, that's fine, thanks. Right, well, I'll see you anon.
Bye, David.
Bye.
Oh, well done. Thought for a minute he was going to stay.
Yeah, well, I hope Jackie turns up soon, because my nerves are shot. I don't think I can stand much more of this.
Why now didn't you agree on a time?
Anyway, good to see you, mate. Don't leave it so long the next time.
No, I won't. And don't forget to invite me to the wedding of the year.
No. Anyway, take care of yourself. And if that Finnegan causes you any grief, you know where to come. That's the trouble with these amateurs. They don't know how to run things. They just don't know the rules.
They don't know when they're out of the league.
Anyway, you want to deal with them? Feel free. I've no objections. And you won't have to look for volunteers to help you take him out.
Well, it's only early days yet, Bob, but I was just curious about him, that's all.
All right.
See ya.
See ya.
Have you seen my briefcase?
It's by the chair. Are you going out?
Yep. I've got a pile of paperwork to plough through at the office.
Burning the midnight oil, eh?
I wish you'd tell me what's wrong.
Oh, it's not.
Come on, Holly, you've hardly said a word to me all evening. Is it Dan?
No.
So it is me?
No. Well, yes. Sort of.
For God's sake, Ollie.
Can we drop the subject, please?
It suits me fine. Don't wait up. I'm going to stay at the flat tonight.
There's no need.
Why? What's the alternative? Staying here with you? I don't think so. I know where I'm not wanted.
I feel like I'll cover an interview or something.
Oh, no, not at all, no. Oh, Max, pour Jackie a drink.
It's all right, I don't want one, thanks.
Oh, well, I'm going to have one. Susanna, would you,
No, I'm fine, thank you. So, what was it you wanted to talk to me about?
Well, I was, we were both wondering, Susanna and I, whether or not...
What Max is trying to say is, we'd like to make you an offer. An offer? What sort of offer?
Well, we've checked it out and we've researched it all quite thoroughly and, £15,000 seems to be, a very fair price.
£15,000? Mm-hmm. Well, for what? Have I missed something here?
You know, when you were talking to me earlier about your money troubles, about you getting involved in things way over your head, we think we might have the solution to all your problems.
Oh? You mean you want to invest money into Bar Brookie?
No. Not exactly.
Well, yes. Well, in a way. Oh, I'm sorry, but you've lost me here.
Well, obviously, you need the money, and, well, we're desperate for a baby, and you've always said you didn't want any children of your own, and, well, £15,000 seems, more than enough to compensate for the inconvenience, and, after all, it is only for 9 months.
Is this some kind of wind-up?
No. It's a genuine offer.
We want you to have our baby.
Yeah, give us a look.
Oh, get off, will you? It needs freezing.
You pay more attention to that than you do me. Bet you won't even miss me when I go to the army.
Nice. Here you go. I need to change.
Sir. Yeah, can I take your forks?
Yeah, go on. Enjoy your meal.
Right, sir.
Hi, Lynn.
Hiya.
Yeah, do some portions with chips, will you?
Okay. So, do you have a good night with your mates?
Yeah, sir. Ow! They're up then.
They're supposed to be. They've only just been cooked. Salt and vinegar?
Yeah, sir. What time do you finish?
What?
I just wondered if you want to come for a drink with us when you knock off.
No, you're all right.
I know I'm all right. And you're pretty nice yourself. So about come for a drink with us?
I can't. My mum's watching Carly for me. I told her I wouldn't be late.
So about tomorrow, then?
I can't, if it. I've got a booking at a club. I do a bit of singing.
Ah? So as well as looking good, you do a bit of singing as well, eh?
You haven't heard me yet.
That's true. Might have to do something about that, then. See you, Lynn.
See ya.
What do you think I am, eh? Rent a womb? Not at all. We just thought... Oh, I know exactly what you thought. Let's go and take advantage of Jackie Dixon, everybody else's.
Jackie, I can assure you that was never our intention.
And you? Of all a cheek. I told you my problem's incompetence. And what you do, eh? Run home and tell your little wife so that you can cook up a plan to use it to your advantage? How low can you stoop, eh?
No, it wasn't like that. We're losing Matthew and Emily and we're desperate for a baby. It just made sense.
Oh, it might make sense to you, but it doesn't to me. You're just trying to capitalise on someone else's misfortune. Well, I am very sorry, but it's not going to be mine. Do you know, you are a sad, pathetic couple. You're sick. It's not a baby you need. It's a psychiatrist.
You could be heading for road rage from the comfort of your armchair. There are frank views on, and sometimes from, women drivers. Fasten your seatbelts for Cutting Edge next on 4.
It's Brookside now on 4, and don't forget that next week there's a visit to the close every night.
Just come right out and ask the neighbour to have a baby for them.
15,000 is an awful lot of money. Max and Susanna must be desperate. And why don't just try for another one themselves?
Telling me it'll only take 9 months like it was nothing. 9 months of morning sickness and walking around like Mrs. Blobby.
Maybe they've tried. Maybe Susanna can't.
And why chose you then?
Yeah, well, whatever the reason, they'll have to go and use someone else's womb as an oven, because they're not having mine.
Can I feel sorry for them though, you know? Well, it must be terrible when your kids like that.
Yeah, I suppose so. I remember how bad it was losing our Tony. Maybe I should have been a little bit more understanding. Now the whole thing's just insane, isn't it?
I won't pretend I'm not disappointed. Because I am, but at least I know we tried our best. If it's not meant to be, then it's just not meant to be. Maybe it's time to stop chasing dreams, Max. I mean,
Lisa hasn't got any children. And she feels satisfied and fulfilled as a woman, so why can't I be?
You can. And you will be. I promise you.
Hi.
Oh, hi. So how are you feeling today?
I'm okay. I've come bearing an olive branch.
Oh, yes, and what might that be?
Dinner at Grant's tonight.
I'll have to check my diary.
Well, perhaps you can see if you've got a window free later, because I'd like to make up for my behaviour last night.
And are you going to tell me what that was all about?
Really, it's not worth talking about. I was just stressed out, that's all. But if you'll grace me with your company tonight, then I promise I'll be the perfect dinner date.
Now, there's an offer I can't refuse. But I've got a late appointment, so it's probably best if I meet you down there.
Great. Well, I'll book a table this afternoon. I better be getting off to work.
Oh, Yui! I'm collecting for the poppy appeal, so get your hands in your pockets.
I'll just go and get some change.
I'll make a donation, but I don't want a pocket. I only wear the white ones.
Fair enough. Oh, there's that Barry Grant.
Who?
Oh, you don't know him, do you? And believe you me, you don't want to either. He's trouble with a capital T. He used to live along the close.
Really? Well, I'll see you later.
Yeah, bye. Are you all right?
Sorry, love. Oh, pardon me for staring, but you know what? You're a dead ringer for Ollie Simpson's daughter, Georgie, with your hair like that.
Really?
Yeah, it's uncanny.
Hiya.
Hello.
Penny for them.
You were friends, man?
Oh, sorry. I didn't realise.
You're all right. Hey, that's bad for your image, that, you know. Supposed to be a big singer, aren't you?
I never said that.
You're singing somewhere tonight, where is it?
You've got a good memory, haven't you?
I have when it's something important.
Right, better get back inside.
Lins.
What?
You forgot your brush.
Oh, right.
Hello again. Haven't you got a home to go to?
Hey, no one said that to you when you were staying in ours.
No, you've got a short memory, haven't you? That's all you ever used to say. Any more tea going?
The kettle's just boiled.
I'll get one some of that.
Thanks, Sharon. I forgot I had all these. By the time I get up to Bristol, they're not even a fit, are Ruth?
Well, why don't you go down and see her then?
I'd love to, but it's not that easy, is it? Working in the shop on my own, I've got no one to cover for me. Unless you'd like to do the odd day or two.
You're joking, aren't you? I've got my training to do, haven't I? I can't just be sitting around all day. Well, why don't you post them?
Looks like I'm going to have to. Unless Rachel's planning to go and visit Mandy, I'll have to ask her.
Yeah.
Well, thanks, Shan.
So what do you want to do then? Jump the bus down to us?
Yeah, okay. I'm not just yet, I want to watch some telly.
Jump the bus? What happened to all this training, like? Shouldn't you be walking?
Well, I would if it was just me, but it's not. I could walk for miles. It's her, isn't it? And she's only a girl. Feet probably couldn't take it. I'd have to end up carrying her.
Listen to the big strong sword you're talking. Careful, it might go to your head.
Hey, what are you doing? Come on.
Well, we can't complain about the takings, that's for sure.
Dad, it's not the money I'm worried about. It's like it's not my barn anymore. Finnick's just taken over. I want this place to be back in my control so I can run it the way I want to.
Oh, counting your good fortune, are you?
What can we do for you, Julia? We're having a bit of a meeting here.
It won't take a minute. I was just wondering if you'd be interested in sharing some of your good fortune with the poppy peel.
Look, Juliet, do you mind coming back later? We're a bit busy just now.
When I think of the sacrifices that those young men made for us, not like you, you youngsters today.
Julia.
All you think about is yourselves.
Julia, we are more than willing to donate, but it's just that now is not a good time. Just give us half an hour.
All right. That's what they all say, and they've no intentions of sparing as much as a penny.
Right, right. Here you go. There's 50 of them. OK, satisfied. Thank you very much indeed. Goodbye.
How far have you got those?
Well, we've still got all them to do here.
I'm afraid I left rather a lot for when we got back. It's been a bit hectic without you here to help.
Yeah, well, I'm back now. You really suit your hair like that, you know. I'd love to do something different with mine, but I haven't got the bottle. Wouldn't mind, but my best mate owns a hair salon.
Sometimes I just fancy a different look. Do I remind you of anyone with my hair like this?
Someone famous like?
No, no, forget it. It was just something someone said.
Well, give us a clue then. Is he a pop star or one of those presenters off GMTV?
It isn't anybody famous. It's just that Julia mentioned that I look like Ollie's daughter, Georgia.
Oh, right. Yeah, I suppose you do a bit. Why would you think?
Well, I've never actually met her. Or his eldest son, Nat. He never really seems to have much to do with them.
Why don't you sneak a look at a photo of her?
Well, I would if I could. There don't seem to be any of them around the house. There's loads of Dan, but none of the others. He never mentions them. It's really odd.
I don't really know that much about it. Have you asked Ollie?
Oh, yeah, sorry to bother you. Is it all right if I have a quick word with Katie?
Yeah, of course.
Hiya, Kate. I've just knocked at Rachel's and there's no answer. Has she gone out anywhere?
Yeah, she's going to have to stay with the mum for a while.
Oh, she might have let me know. I've got a load of stuff there for Ruthie. She could have took it down for me.
Well, I don't think it was planned. I think it all happened in a bit of a rush, you know, after what happened with Christian.
What happened with Christian?
Don't you know?
No, I don't.
Well, look, ask Jackie. I wasn't even here when it happened.
Katie, when what happened?
Honestly, Sinbad, I think you better speak to Jackie about it. I don't know the details.
Thanks, love.
Okay.
Hi, Julia.
God bless and save us. You nearly gave me a corona, alright? I didn't see you there, love.
How are you doing?
I'm fine, thanks. And how long have you been back?
A few days.
Oh, really?
Oh, come off it, Julia. I know things have changed around here, but you not knowing I was back, things can't have changed that much.
Yeah, well, doesn't revolve around you, Barry Grant.
Well, maybe not, but you always have had your ear to the ground, haven't you, Julia?
I hope you're not accusing me of being nosy.
Oh, no, no. I was just wondering if you knew anything that was going on over at the bar there, you know, with all the bouncers and stuff.
Well, I'm not normally one to get involved in industrial espionage.
Well, it's hardly that, is it?
But if you stick something in there, I might be persuaded to talk.
Well, thanks very much, Jack. I mean, you could have let me know sooner.
Hey, don't be blaming me. I only found out right at the last minute, and anyway, it wasn't for me to say.
Poor kid, eh? Imagine being driven to those lengths. You must have suffered in silence all that time.
I feel terrible now. I mean, she came to me not long ago, hinting that something wasn't right. I just had no idea. I'm supposed to be looking after them. I mean, how's it going to look to Mandy?
Look, the main thing is it's over. Rachel's never going to take Christian back now. We're just best leaving her to sort things out for herself. That's what she wants.
Lovely. Right, enjoy your meal.
Hi, how have you been getting on?
Very well. I've had a very productive chat with Chef, sorted out the mess that was the rotors. Oh, and I've taken several bookings.
Oh, great.
One of which is for your friend Ollie. He and a certain lady solicitor will be dining here this evening.
Oh, wow. Well, I'm surprised you allowed that. What would Belle say?
Business is business.
You're a hard woman.
Yes, and judging by the amount of paperwork I've got to plough through here, it's just as well.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I've heard of unfinished business. This is ridiculous.
Well, all I can say is it's wonderful to have you back in the swing of things.
Mm-hmm. Not a moment before time.
Yeah, good.
It's all of it. We keep the change.
Hello. Back again, I see.
Yeah, can't keep away. Nice little gaff, this.
Ta.
Yeah, it's always busy. Good clientele. You must be raking it in, Ron.
Well, can't complain, you know.
Yeah, nice little setup.
except for one thing. That blurt on the door.
You what?
That Callum. You want to watch him?
Why do you know him, like?
Not personally, no. But I know his type. If you want my advice, you want to nip it in the bud before it's too late.
Yeah, well, no need to concern yourself, because we've got it all in hand. Anyway, we're thinking about letting him go.
If you want to watch yourself, Ron. His type don't let go so easily.
But are you like the flavour proper to deal with something? Listen, if me and our Jackie say so, he's history, OK? We don't need any jumped security in here. We can look after ourselves.
Ron, you can't run a bar without security. It goes with the territory.
Oh, really? Well, I've managed to get by running a business on my own all these years. So I don't need anybody hold me hand now just because I've branched out into a different field.
A different field? You're in a completely different world, Ron. You're out of your depth. You can't mess around with the likes of Finnegan. If you wanted a quiet life, you're in the wrong game, mate. You should have stuck to selling tins of beans.
Some money.
Why don't you just sit down and let the driver do his job?
Why don't you shut up and mind your own business?
You cheeky little half a man, just clip you over the hole.
Wanna try it?
She's gonna get hurt in a minute.
Well, if you stayed in and watched Coronation Street like you're supposed to, you wouldn't get yourself in trouble now, would you?
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Get lost.
I don't think so.
She started it.
What do you mean she started it? Do you think you're hard, arguing with an old lady, eh?
Hey, you. Yes, Sophia.
Are you all right?
Yes, thanks, love. I'm getting off here.
That's funny, lads. So are we.
Come in, Shaz. We're getting off here, no? It's all right, Mrs. Brogan. Me and Shannon will walk it home.
Oh, thanks very much, love. I appreciate your company.
Come on, lads. She's got her bodyguards with her.
You're a treasure. Oh.
Max, that looks fantastic. Doesn't it, Holly?
Yeah, very appetizing.
Well, I'm glad it meets your approval.
Mmm, it's delicious. Try some.
Mmm, very nice.
Right, I'll leave you to it. Sorry about that.
Really, Max, you shouldn't encourage them.
Oh, I see, and what happened to business is business, eh?
Look at her. She's all over him.
How's yours?
Mmm. Very good.
Mm. It's just nice to be having a meal together in relaxed surroundings.
I know. We should do this more often.
Well, as much as anything else, it gives us an opportunity to really talk.
Ah, the dreaded T word.
Holly, I'm serious.
Oh, so am I. That word, when uttered by a female, can freeze a man's blood 50 paces. I'm sorry. You obviously have an agenda.
Well, there is something that's been bothering me, yes. It all stems from yesterday.
I apologise for the way I behaved.
Yeah, but it's why that concerns me. I've thought about it. You were fine until I came back from the salon. It's my new image, isn't it? It's my hair.
Don't be ridiculous.
At first I thought they must be wrong. Gentlemen don't prefer blondes. But...
what?
Today a couple of people said I reminded them of someone. And then it all started to fit into place.
Eleanor.
The reason you've been funny with me, I look like your daughter, don't I?
Sorry, love.
What did he say?
I'm on in between the bingo. Have you seen this place? I feel ashamed. I murdered that Ron Dixon when I see him.
What? Look. You know, it's not brilliant. It might be. You've got to start somewhere, haven't you?
Oh, you're joking, aren't you? Peter, what do you think this place is? Grab a granny night. You wouldn't be seeing Daddy if you didn't have to be here with me.
Oh, I don't know. Bingo's always been one of my faves.
What did Bingo want?
Oh, don't be daft. They'll love you. Come on, let's go to the dressing room. I'll do your makeup for you. Come on.
I'm going to miss you, Lynx, but I can't wait for my holiday in Bali.
Freudian going out with someone who bears a resemblance to your daughter, but...
It is slightly unnerving, yes.
Well, surely we could have talked about it. I mean, it's as though you're blaming me, shutting me out. This isn't deliberate, you know.
I know.
I mean, how could it be? I've never even seen a photograph of Georgia, or Nat for that matter.
Neither of them have got anything to do with you, that's why.
But I don't understand. He wanted me to be involved in Dan's life. Well, why not Nat and George's? I mean, they're your children too.
Can we end this conversation, please?
Well, quite frankly, I don't think it's a very healthy start to a relationship to be keeping secrets from each other.
How can you say that? I've been more than open about me with you. You're the one who's holding back. But when it comes to my family, I'm sorry, but it's a different story.
Well? Ollie, you can't stop there. You've got me imagining all kinds of things. I mean, nothing can be that bad, surely.
This is neither the time nor the place. Let's go home, and I'll tell you all about the lovely Simpson family, and you can answer that for yourself.
What are you doing here?
I just came to see what time you're on. I don't want to stay in here too long. It's bad for my image. I just came to see you sort your stuff.
You can go now, because I'm not going on.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the bingo will start in about 5 minutes.
I don't
minutes,
feel well.
But I'm afraid one of the turns will not be appearing due to illness.
Oh, yeah.
Barry was just saying he's brought his girlfriend to see me singing.
Oh, right. Looks like you're going to be disappointed, isn't it?
Your children are living together as a couple. I don't know what to say.
Well, now you know why I was slightly reluctant to let you know all the gory details.
God, it must have been a terrible shock for you.
Oh, it was great fun. Not as entertaining as when the whole neighbourhood found out. And when my wife accused me of being the cause of it all.
What do you mean?
Belle thought that I was capable of abusing my own daughter. Which is why she started sleeping with her brother.
But it wasn't true, though. Was it?
Oh, great. Not you as well. Of course not.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean... Well, it's just I'm finding it all a little difficult to take in.
You are? Oh, believe me, so am I. And I've been to family therapy.
So, last night, the reason you were upset with me is because I remind you of your daughter. I'm sorry something so stupid should have brought it all back to you.
You weren't to know. You've got nothing to feel sorry for. I obviously thought I'd buried it deeper than I had, that's all.
I can change it back if you like. I mean, it's no problem if it's going to make things difficult for you.
No, no. No, it suits you. You just ignore me, that's all.
Right then, my round. I take it we're all sticking to what we had before, yeah?
Yeah, sir.
Oh, I'll go down there and get them, I guess. OK.
So, how are you feeling, man?
All right. Just evidence you're on Dixon. He asked me how the gig went. He'll kill me when he finds out I didn't do it. Can I get you a drink? Peter's already got them, thanks, Jack. Oh, okay. So, is your girlfriend?
My girlfriend? What makes you think she's my girlfriend?
Well, she is, isn't she?
Are you asking me or telling me? Well, she's a girl, and she is my friend. But what you really want to know is, am I sleeping with her? And the answer is, no. So, what did I miss then?
do you mean?
Lee's show. What songs do you do?
Oh, I only do Cher stuff, that's all.
Oh, you used to like it yourself.
Well, did you? I've just started a record collection, but some of them have been deleted. You know, they're really hard to get hold of.
Yeah, you can't get them anywhere, can you?
Which part?
Oh, she's just gone to powder her nose. She probably met someone, started having a gab.
Yeah.
Hey, listen, will you do us a favour? When she comes back from the ladies, will you tell her I've just gone to sort out a bit of business?
Yeah, OK, mate.
Make a lovely couple, don't they?
Yeah.
Not as nasty as us, do they?
So what did you want to talk to me about?
Hey, it's about this Finnegan fella.
What about him?
So he's made you sign a contract then, eh?
Yep.
So, there's not much you can do about it.
Tell me something I don't already know.
No, you're not listening properly. I said there's not much that you can do. Doesn't mean to say that something can't be done.
Okay, so have you got something in mind? £30,000! What's this?
You pay me that. And Finnegan will be out of this bar for good.
Do I look stupid? We don't even pay Finnegan this much.
I'm talking about a one-off payment, that's all. Finnegan's going to be creaming off your profits for life. I don't think he's going to be happy with what he's getting now. He'll get greedier and greedier. You think about it. You accept my offer, and I guarantee you, he won't be in here again. It's up to you.
Marital bliss is not a Tour de France. It's the real holiday show next on 4.
Evander Holyfield, let's get down off the chair.
And in the red corner, Private Tim O'Leary, the 1st Airborne Division, the Paris. Right there, right!
No, strictly cash. A grand we said, yeah?
Because that'd be petty cash to you these days. I told you we'd have this place buzzing.
Can you leave that alone, please? That's private.
Are these last week's figures? Now, see what happens when you keep the no marks out. Am I right or am I right? Please, don't stop.
Everything all right, Jack?
Your beautiful daughter's just sorting out the financial stuff. I tell you what, see, if this continues, you're soon going to need another doorman. Now, whether I tell you, Jackie, what's good for you is good for me and vice versa. Hey, what's the bets? 6 months' time, you're going to buy yourself a nice wee can cruiser. You look tired. You need a spot of sun. I'd suggest some island hopping. The Aegean's quite nice. Florida Keys.
Dad, you go back and keep an eye on the bar.
Sure.
Yeah. I'll be honest there.
One thing I wanted to say. I'd change the tapes if I was you. You want something more middle road, you know? A bit more upmarket. One another thing. And get rid of that tall guy you sometimes use behind the bar, you know? Fair-haired bloke. Total waste of space.
That's my brother.
Sorry. No offence.
You forced him a punch back?
He found it?
Yeah, we went to a house clearing. Some owl fella who used to be the bantamweight boxing champion of the world in the 50s.
Oh, yeah. And what did he have? A mashed brain?
How much?
It's dead sound. Yeah, do you want to go?
Me? Yeah, put them on. Go ahead.
What's going on? They've got a punch bag, haven't they? Oh, can I have a go?
No, your mum's first.
More of a useless.
Dead right.
Oh, go on, Tim, let me have a go. I'm calling for Toppy.
Can I?
Hey, early see you tonight, Mum.
Oh, yeah, you've got your play, haven't you?
Is your Tim around? Why, what's he done now?
Tim, Mrs. Brogan to see you.
Oh, no, no, nothing like that. I'm just popping round to say thank you.
What for?
For the other night.
Why, what happened the other night?
Oh, didn't he tell you?
Hiya.
No.
Hiya. About the bus?
What bus?
Oh, I'm going to have to revise my opinion about you, young man, aren't I? Oh, he's not all about nicking cars and mugging old ladies, is he? Well, all I can say is thanks very much, love.
It's okay.
What exactly did he do?
Nothing.
Nothing? Oh, Mr. Modesty and all, eh?
Just a bit of trouble on the bus.
A bit? Them lads could have been carrying knives.
Morning, everybody.
Oh, hello, Dave. And there was your Tim with his girlfriend. He sorted them little nomads out like a proper hero. Well, I've got a little thank you for you, love. Boot nut. And no arguments.
Ta.
Sounds like you acquitted yourself splendidly, Timothy.
Anyway, here's that book I've been looking for. 6 months Among the Gurkhas. I think you'll find that interesting.
Well, I'm afraid he doesn't read that much.
I do sometimes. Thanks.
Anyway, time and tide and all that, I'm off for cash and carry.
Well, do you want a hand?
Well, yes, why not?
Well, I'll just go and change, OK?
I'll ring you from Dublin.
OK.
And Singapore tomorrow morning.
What am I doing here? I don't want to go anywhere.
It's only 10 days, Peter.
It's 240 hours. I can't manage 240 hours alone.
Oh, God, no. Not in a dump like Bali with 12 stunning models, though. Poor old you. 10 minutes and you'll forget about me.
Let's get married.
Now?
Well, engaged then. Let's get engaged. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. I know you're not sure.
I am sure.
Well, move in with me then. You want to come and live with me, don't you, Kylie?
Yeah.
You see, you're outvoted. God, listen to me. I'm like a gibbering wreck. Creeping down your dad's stairs every morning at dawn. Well, you've got to move in. Say yes, please. I love you. What? It's just what?
I can't risk Kylie getting hair for a third time.
Mommy.
She's had too many upsets.
Well, that's because you hadn't met me yet, wasn't it? I mean, you were bound to meet all those wrong blokes, weren't you? Oh, you got to do it, Lynn. Say yes, please. I won't give up, ever.
I do love you, Peter.
Of course, that's the trouble with the buses since derelegation. The kids, feet on seats, sniffing lighter fuel. Plus, I blame the parents myself. And the cheek that they gave that poor driver. Oh. Anyway, so that's what I'm going to do.
Pardon?
Well, I'm not risking travelling on public transport anymore. Oh, no. I'm going to learn how to drive.
It cost you a lot of money, Julia. Driving lessons are expensive.
Oh, I'm not having those driving lessons. Oh, no. I'm not paying some young fella 12 quid an hour. No, I'm just hoping that some kind person's going to help me.
Sorry, that took a bit longer than I thought.
Putting the world to rights?
Well, doing the best we can.
Right, Timothy, we'd better make a move. I'll see you later, Julia.
All right. See you later, Dave. And don't forget if you get the odd half hour. Ba-dum, ba-dum. Ooh, I'll be waiting.
Why is he wearing a white poppy? Is he one of those conscious pacifist mings?
Timothy, do you know nothing of modern history?
Well, yeah, I know a bit.
Right. Get in the car, my lad. The cash and carry can wait. Come on.
Every day. I'll ring you every day.
Right. Go on, say bye-bye.
Bye, sweetheart. Bye, darling.
Go on. You'll miss your plane.
I'll think about you all the time. 14,400 minutes. See you.
Bye-bye.
Yes.
Final call for Mr. Peter.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Dana. FR5521 to Dublin.
You welded to that still? Anyway, I thought you lived down south now.
I do.
So when are you going home, like?
Well, there's a couple of things around here that I've got, let's say, attention.
Look, Barry, Jackie told me about your generous offer. But it's not going to happen. Not on this spot. So if you sat there like some flaming vulture waiting for us to crack.
Okay. You get on with it. Sort your own problems out. I've got someone to see now. But I'll be back if you change your minds.
Maybe we should.
Should what?
Change our minds.
What, and pay that gangster 30 grand? No way.
Dad, if he can get rid, it's worth it. That's our choice. A one-off 30 grand fee to Barry Grant. Or 50 grand a year for life to that sewer rat, Callum.
Forsooth?
Oh, forsooth, my lords. I do swear that Signor Guido Fox...
Who wrote this?
I did.
Oh, right.
I'm in the history. We were going to do it as a musical, but we couldn't get enough songs together. And the band had a row.
Nice and early.
Hi.
Hi.
Dan, you're dripping mayonnaise all down your jumper. Don't change this.
Give us that. But I do declare that Signor Fox... is a vile and hideous trait for the crown.
Vile and hideous?
Dan's play.
Oh.
So, listen, I'll be out tonight.
Right.
You wouldn't,
You don't want me to come? To the play?
I won't then.
Oh, no. No, if you...
Look, Ollie, if it's going to make things awkward for you...
No, it isn't. Not at all. I'd like you to come.
Okay, then I'll come.
Well, I could get alone.
No.
Well, have you got a better idea?
Jackie, don't even think about loans. The bank aren't going to sub you, are they? So it's going to be some backstreet loan shark. And all right, so you give guarantee it's 30 grand. What guarantees have you got then, eh? Got loans down the line, Finnegan could be back. Not him, someone worse.
Dad, what's wrong with your arm?
Oh, what if Grant just takes the money and buggers off again? You know, he's one of the dodgiest characters this side of Argentina. He's dangerous, Jackie. Don't get mixed up with him.
Is it the angina?
Yeah, what? No, it's just a... Jack, don't you see Finnegan, Grant? It's the same difference. They're both sewer rats. Whichever way you look at it, you're throwing your money away. What's the bet we don't finish up with a pair of them slimy leeches trying to suck us dry? No, there has got to be another way.
That was years ago. I mean, it was all history.
Not to them it wasn't, Tim. To them, it was now. Do you know... some of these lads were only 16 years old.
16? My age?
They lied about their age to get to the front. Half of them didn't have any idea what they were fighting for. When they did get there, well, it was shells and poison gas and smashed limbs and blood and gangrene.
But it was exciting, though.
You think so? You know, some of these boys went... well, they went mad with the fear and they just ran, screaming out of the trenches.
What happened to them?
They were shot as deserters.
Seen that? Two Morans?
Yeah. Brothers, probably.
At least they died for the country, eh?
Do you think that made their mother proud? I wonder how proud the women were who lost husbands in the First World War and sons in the Second. I wonder how much pride came into it. You see, that's why Ollie Simpson wears a white poppy. It's to honor those that died, yes, but it's a protest against war. All war.
But that's soft. I mean, you've got to fight. Look at Saddam Hussein. You've got to.
It's almost a millennium, you know. And we still haven't found a better way.
That's what I reckon soldiers do. They keep the peace.
I am the enemy you killed, my friend. What passing bells for these who die as cattle? by the monstrous anger of the guns.
Pull the chain lever and wash your hands when you're finished.
Can I come in?
We've only just got in.
Yeah, I don't know. Boyfriend gone. So do we stand out here or
Come on. Yeah.
Pleasure for you.
What is it? The share tracks, how did you find them? Oh, I don't know what to say.
So, dinner?
Pardon?
I'm asking you out.
I can't.
Oh, I see. Waiting for the boyfriend to ring, eh? Well, how about tomorrow, then?
No, I'm sorry now.
Well, it's all right. I can wait. You tell me when you're ready. I'll see you.
Peter? Oh, no. No, I'm fine. I'm just missing you.
Supposed to be James the First.
He is.
Send for a serving wench.
I thought James the First was gay.
And a flask of the French Malmsey.
You sent for me, sire?
There's our mail.
Madam, I sent for a serving wench. Who are you?
Forgive me, sire, but I am Lady Fox.
Where did she get the bosoms from?
Do what you will with me, my lord, but spare my husband's head.
So that's why Danny suddenly got interested in acting.
Madam, the cause of justice must not be perverted.
Guess what happened to Millie Wonderbra?
Please don't waste it, wench. Your husband will stand trial before his peers. Until then, he will sweat.
Have mercy, sire.
Despite your obvious charms, my mind is set.
Poor Mick, that bloody trial. He's not allowed to forget it for 5 minutes.
Is the axe?
Hey, don't let Julia see your dad. I think she's got the monopoly on the poppies.
Poppies, come on. Come on, lads, it's for the Legion. Thanks a lot now. Thank you. Anybody else now? Poppies?
No one here, Ron. You're annoying the customers. Leave that in the bar.
Who's running this place?
Just a bit of friendly advice.
Yeah, well, keep your friendly advice for those who need it.
Dad.
It's ironic, isn't it, Finnegan? My old fella and his generation fought and died to keep Britain free from scum like you.
Come on, Dad.
So where's your poppy then, Ron?
It's right here.
Not as patriotic as we thought, are we?
Yes. How should we live to that, actually?
It's not now, leave it.
How's that for patriotic? Hey? Hand there! Is that patriotic enough?
Calm down. Give your blood pressure a rest. Problem is, young man's game this. Sorry, young woman's. Excuse me.
Hey. I know your game. You've had your eye on this place from day one, haven't you?
I'm talking to my friends.
Do you know what? It is so obvious it's pathetic. Bleed the bar dry till it's worth virtually nothing, and the buyer's out dead and cheap.
I've doubled your profits, Ron. Is that bleeding you dry?
Softened us up more likely.
Dad.
Go away.
All right, then. Let's cut the crap, shall we? Make me an offer.
What are you playing at? Take no notice of them.
I'm sick of the place.
It is not yours to sell.
Come on, then, mouth. How much is it worth? Come on, make me an offer.
Shut up, Dad. Don't listen to him. I am not selling.
Don't worry, darling. I'm no buy.
This place has been nothing but trouble. If he wants it, Jackie, let him have it.
In the office, Dad, now. Now.
You think I want your poxy bar?
I'm in security, no catering. Take that old man home, eh? He's a bloody embarrassment.
Thank you.
Wasn't Melanie wonderful?
Mmm, stunning.
All right, then. Well, I'll go and talk to Mr. Murphy. See you later.
Okay.
So, who's Mr. Murphy?
Dance history teacher. So I'd better run.
Okay, I'll wait here.
Oh, no, no, no. I didn't mean...
I'm not Belle. I don't have the right to go and talk to Danny's teacher.
I thought you might want to. Look, Eleanor, about the other night...
Is that all now?
I'm just over there, that's cool.
I'll tell you where, you go and find Melanie, get something to eat, eh? I'll see you in a bit.
See you later, kids.
Good night, Jim. God bless her. So, how many more bonfire nights for the kids, eh?
Oh, come on now.
Next year, strange ways.
Hey, none of that. We just enjoy the moment. Gemma's doing fine. Leo's in the play at school. Everyone there's forgotten about it.
Oh, you're joking, aren't you, sir? I nearly didn't come tonight. No one's forgotten. I'm sick of people staring at me and whispering.
Well, they're probably the same ones that bought them frozen pies off you.
Sick bad.
Well, I got smiled, didn't I? Cheers.
You haven't got a clue what this means to me.
Look, all I want...
Don't you ever, ever do that again. This ball is not for sale, got it? This ball's mine.
Well, actually...
No, Dad, mine. And I will cut my wrists open. I'll put a bullet through my mouth before I let it go to anyone, because this is not just some crackpot little mobile shop. This is me, Jackie Dixon, making it on my own from nothing. OK, I didn't go to university, I didn't have capital, but I made it. I took the risks. And I'm going to be bigger than anyone round here. And 10 years from now, you and my mum are going to have everything you've ever wanted, lap of luxury. But what I don't need, what I really don't need, is you interfering with things you don't understand.
Is everything OK?
It's private. So never, ever offer to sell up over my head again. Now, is that 100% clear? Because if not, I don't want you in the bar. You can stay at home. Dad, what's wrong? Oh, my God. Barry! Sit down. Barry! Barry! Dad!
What's up with him?
Quick, get an ambulance. It's his heart.
Loosen his collar.
Dad, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to shout at you. Dad, say something.
Hello, ambulance.
This is all really the girl's fault.
Yeah, 274-8196.
Dad, are you going to be okay? We're getting some help.
Yeah,
okay. Oh.
Manor Park. Oh.
God, help! Someone help!
You're not cold, are you?
No. Just Dad got that though, wasn't it?
Yeah.
We should like do a proper play. More rehearsals and that.
Can I?
Can you what?
Can I kiss you?
Okay.
No.
Do it again, then. You're fast.
There's one lonely, frightened man.
Yeah, but imagine having something like that hanging over you.
Yeah.
Hey, you've been looking for you everywhere.
Well, where's our Mel?
I don't know why.
But she's vanished off the face of the earth again. Hang on, I'll go and find her.
Oh, I'll see you in a minute.
Hey, Sinbad. Sorry for that. You know, that boxing bag. Salma.
Hey, listen. You did a good thing on the bus the other day. I mean, why didn't you tell us?
Because it was nothing. Hey, do you think my mum would be proud when I'm a soldier?
Well, it depends on what sort of a soldier you become, doesn't it?
I wasn't sure that you believed me when I told you that I didn't abuse my daughter, and I just wanted to tell you that I didn't do it.
Ollie, I know you didn't.
Do you?
You're not a child abuser, and I admit enough, believe me. Oh, come here.
Everything else, though, everything else was true.
So what if you never saw your eldest two again? I mean, would you face that?
Already faced it.
Yeah, sometimes it's the only option, isn't it? Some things you just have to let go.
Where did that come from?
Oh, no. Nothing. I just mean, well, you know, you see a lot of extraordinary things at work.
You're beautiful.
Can someone find out Mike and tell him what's happened?
You gonna be okay, Jackie?
All right, Barry. Do it. Get rid of Finnegan for me.
You sure?
I want him off our back.
It's gonna cost you 30 grand.
I'll get it. Don't worry about your precious bloody money. I'll get it for you.
There's a special week of Brookside with the first of 5 episodes next Monday at 8:30. Now settle back for comedy, comedy and probably a bit of comedy. Ross gets his stuff back from Rachel next, those former friends. First of 5 episodes this week of Brookside.
Quiz?
No, he doesn't.
Don't let the old grey matters up to it, son.
Do you need anything else, Brinkerton?
I'd mind a cop at the exchange of Mart, see if they got any decent second-hand tickers.
Hey, the one you've got is fine.
Listen, love, if my heart was a car, we'd be looking at a clapped-out old Robin Reliance.
Oh, don't sell yourself short, Dad. It's at least a Skoda.
Shut up, you.
He's only joking, love.
Yeah, well, if you want to do something useful, go and get us all a cup of tea.
Go and get it yourself. Do you want anything, Dad?
How about an instant transplant? Milk, no sugar, thanks. Come easy on him, eh, love?
Yeah, but he's such a dead leg.
You gonna be all right on your tod in that bar?
Don't worry about it.
Bit late for that, isn't it?
I'm serious, it's boxed off.
How do you mean? Oh, no. Jackie, not Barry Grant.
Yeah.
But 30,000 quid, love, where are you going to get your hands on?
I'll get it.
Not from bloody loan sharks, I hope.
Don't get yourself all hairs off, Dad.
Jackie, do you know what them fellas do if you don't cough up on time?
Nobody said anything about loan sharks, did they?
Then where?
Dad, trust me. I'll get it sorted.
Hi.
Hi.
Do you want
some salad? No, thanks. I just nipped back to see if I could catch you in.
Consider me called.
I wanted a word this morning, but you were off like a shot.
Fire away.
It's about our little accident last night.
I love it when you go euphemistic on me. Is the phrase burst condom just a little too graphic for a poor repressed book dealer?
Ha ha. Have you done anything about it?
I ran straight into the bathroom and stamped my feet for half an hour.
Strange, but I don't see potential parenthood as much of a laughing matter.
sorry.
If it had been me, I'd have been straight down to the GP like a shot to get the morning after pill.
Yes, well, it isn't you.
No, but still.
Look, I had a pile of paperwork the size of K2 this morning. I just didn't have time.
But you'll find time later.
I'll try, all right?
So what do you fancy for dinner, Mum?
Set a soup and do me. Don't have our hungry artist there.
Oh, flour, stupid plastic bags.
You need another bag?
Put them in the pram, love.
Right.
Any side.
Come on, I'm starving.
Glad to see you.
Not ever see you, babe.
I'll meet you in there.
What?
Go on, but I'll dock you ages. Any chance of a quick chat?
What, now?
Yeah?
Just give us a couple of minutes, eh?
Shall I put me in the next bed to Ron Dixon?
Sorry, darling.
She was just showing me where your arm is.
Pardon me?
We're just having a dry run before Julia starts her driving lessons.
And I believe you've very kindly offered to be my instructor while I get the hang of it.
Well, there's no point in her spending good money till she knows the basics, is there?
Yeah, but...
I can't wait to go in that posh car of yours.
My car?
Oh, I'll feel like Jack Hunt.
James?
No, Jack. He lived next door to me and my Arthur. Drove like a maniac. Didn't do him any good, though, because all the lollipop men from round about, they all got together and they battered him up one night outside the White Horse, it was. Should have seen the face on him. He had eyes like pig's totters for a fortnight. Oh, do you know, it's going to be great, you and me, isn't it? Just like them Welsh people on the telly.
Bye, darling.
Ta-ra, love.
There you go, cheers.
How's your dad?
You what?
I had to visit him myself, but I had to meet him.
He gave me a message for you. It ended in off.
Lovely to hear he's keeping his spirits up.
All right, Jack.
Hiya.
You give Ron all my best, okay?
How's he doing?
He's knackered. God knows how long he's going to be in hospital for.
So, do you want to call the deal off then?
What?
He's at the moment and all that.
No, it's on.
Are you sure?
Do I look like I'm due?
30k?
Unless you do a discount for his heads.
Here you go, grub's up. Thanks. Right, buddy.
Not bad.
So, what did happen to the Angus one day?
Oh, he was just talking the usual crap.
Yeah, no one did evolution, eh?
Michael's customers.
Yeah, listen, if he gives you any more ass.
Yeah, I'll know exactly who to come to.
So how are you going to get the money?
Well, that's my business.
And mine if you don't get it.
Well, let's just say I've had an offer that I can't refuse.
You're in some more trouble, eh?
No, I'm just doing something for someone, same as you're doing something for me.
And when will you have the cash?
Well, hold on a minute, there's a few things I need to know first.
Like?
Well, OK. Say you get rid of him, and then you get off yourself. Well, what happens if he comes back?
He won't.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Well, if you're that confident, you won't mind stage payments then?
You what?
15,000 now, and the rest when I haven't seen his ugly gob for a month.
Are you in any position to waggle? All right, then, you're on. A month down the line, if everything's all right, I'll get the rest of my cash. Yeah? In the meantime, any mess with me about, and this place goes up in smoke. Understand?
Never thought I'd see the day.
Hey, leave him alone.
You know what these army types are like? They've got to be spot on.
Yeah, can't wait to see him on the obstacle course.
Fitter than you.
Yeah, in your dreams, sunshine.
What, do these look all right, Mum?
Oh, yeah, lovely.
Hey, the razor sharp, then.
Go on, hanging them up, then, eh?
You'd think he'd split the atom.
Hey, give him a break, will you?
Oh, I just hope he's going to be all right.
Oh, of course he will.
Yeah, you've seen the adverts, haven't you, Ma? It's all skiing and building rope ladders.
Yeah, but the age of him being out there all on his own.
Well, that's all right. I mean, they make mates just like that.
Yeah, everyone mucks in.
Yeah, I mean, they all look out for each other.
But what if he doesn't mix? Or what if he gets picked on?
Oh, he won't.
God knows what'll happen if he doesn't get in. After this big build-up.
Look, will you stop flapping? Here's your tuna, make your butties, and let's send them off in style.
I look forward to my first stage payment, don't I?
Yeah, and in the meantime...
I'll be thinking about how to spend it.
Hold on. Well, we've got a deal.
And?
Well, you're here and he's here. What are you waiting for?
It doesn't work like that, Jack.
It doesn't, I'm paying. Come on, go and have a word with him.
With me by any chance?
Yeah.
I'm all ears.
I was wondering where you got your coat from. I've been looking for one like that for ages.
It's handmade to order by some guy I know back home. I could get your number if you like.
Sounds a bit pricey to me.
They do some nice stuff at Topshop.
Maybe I'll have to try there, then, eh? See ya.
That's the trouble with taste. Near use if you can't afford it.
All right.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah, got you some blooms?
Thanks, I'll put me some water.
Okay. Well, how's your mum?
Great. She was asking about you.
Yeah? How's Ruthie?
Gorgeous.
And when you see she takes after her dad?
So have you got any gossip then?
Nah, you haven't missed much, which is more than can be said for yours truly, yeah?
What?
You're in soft land.
How about?
Oh, I should have noticed something, mate.
No one did. We're the world experts at covering up.
To think, I sat there giving the cheeky little get advice, I could kill him.
It's not worth it, Sinbad. He's a very sad man.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, me too.
Are you all right?
I think so. I had a good chat with my mum.
Oh, she's the expert. Sorry, just feel free to pour that over my head.
No, you're right. She's been through a lot more than I have. She really sorted me out.
Well, I'm glad to hear it. So what are your plans?
Just see how it goes, really.
Are you going to stay here?
Time being.
Well, you don't have to, you know. I mean, there's plenty of room around the house.
Dunno.
Well, Carmel wouldn't mind.
Yeah, but a kid's mind. There's 5 of you there as it is.
And Mitchell made 6.
I think I'll just see how it goes for now.
Well, look, why don't you come round for your tea tonight? We're having a bit of a do.
Thanks, but I've got to unpack.
But look, if there's anything you need...
Thanks.
I mean it, anything at all. You know where I am.
Going out?
Yeah.
You got toothache?
No.
What's up with your chin?
Nothing.
Daniel?
I cut myself.
How?
Shaving. What are you laughing at? It killed, that did.
I'm sorry. If you told me, I'd have bought you your own razor.
It was my first try.
You spot a few bristles coming through, did you?
5 or 6 at least.
Well, remember next time, go with the grain.
Right.
So where is it tonight?
They're having a good luck party next door for Tinhead. It is all right to go, isn't it?
Well, that's okay. He seems to have got his act together of late. Are you, taking anyone? Or?
Melanie sort of invited me. As a friend.
Right. Dan, if this friendship with Melanie, develops in any way, I can trust you to be sensible, can't I?
Hey?
Well, at the end of the day, I can't stop you doing what comes naturally. Particularly, now you've started shaving. But if and when the situation arises, I do hope you'll be aware of the need to take precautions.
Dad, I'm going for sausages on sticks, not to a Roman orgy.
Dan.
Ah, the very woman.
Bathroom free?
Yes.
Great. Did you... Because I have had a swine of an afternoon. All I want now is a long hot soak.
Yes, but... You know, you can hardly see that. What time will you be back?
When I've run out of condoms.
You cooled down yet? Look, I know you've got a lot on your plate. And I know these tossers are messing you around. But don't ever pull a stunt like that again. I'll clock on when I've been weighed in and not before. So you get me the money and I'll do the job, right? I said right!
Action man.
What?
You're gonna miss out on your standing ovation at this rate.
Hey?
All your guests are hanging around downstairs like spare parts.
I can't wait to see the back of me.
Nah, that's just me. Everyone else thinks the sun shines out your ear end.
I'm coming down now.
We'll get a move on, I'm starving.
Hey, I'm gonna look a right divvy if I don't get in, aren't I?
You'll get in. You're exactly the kind of knobhead the army's looking for.
Did you think you'd get in when you want to be a fireman, like?
No. To be honest, I didn't. But that's only natural. Everyone's scared of getting knocked back. I was bricking it when it came to doing me tests, just like you are now. But you've got to be in it to win it. The only real failures are the fellows who bottle out of everything. You're having a go. That's something to be proud of.
If he doesn't shift his backside, I'm going up there and dragging him down by his...
Pickles, anyone?
Thanks, Al.
I think it's brilliant taking something like that on, you know, at your age.
Why? Do you think 43 is too old to learn to drive?
Hey, hey, much as I admire you, the day that you start tearing around the clothes in the Maxmobile is the day I become agoraphobic.
Oh, there he is!
Yeah, yeah! Yay. Well, I now declare this buffy open! Yay. Come on, tuck in! Come on, babe, tuck in.
Are you lurking?
Do you need your back scrubbing?
Not just now, thanks.
So, did you go to the quacks?
Nope.
What about the morning after pill?
What about it?
Well, I presume you can't take it tomorrow, otherwise it would be the morning after pill.
Ergo?
So you're not going to take it?
Pass go and collect £200.
But what if...
I won't be pregnant.
Who says?
All right, not definitely won't. But I'd lay very long odds against it.
But why take the chance?
Why not? If it bothered you so much at the time, you should have worn two.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. But
anyway, I'm not some 15-year-old stuck up a tower block. Even if I was pregnant, I'd cope.
Speak for yourself.
Don't panic, Mr. Mannering. I'm not about to set the CSA on you.
I didn't mean it like that.
Well, how did you mean it then?
Look, if we consent to risk exchanging bodily fluids, then we should have an equal say in what happens if something goes awry.
Whoa! Where did all this we business come from? I'm the one who'd conceive. And I'm the one who'd carry the lump around for 9 months. And I'm the one who left holding the baby. Which means that I'm the one who gets to say whether or not I take the morning after pill and not some bloke I pulled 5 minutes ago.
Is that how you think of me?
No, of course not.
Well, it's good to know where I stand. I'll just leave you in peace.
Stop sulking, you big baby. Water's still warm.
Journey. I thought I'd have a lie down, that's all.
Oh, God, sorry, Rachel, woken you up, haven't I?
Ah, you're all right.
No, I'll get off, let you get some rest.
No, honestly, you're not disturbing me.
Well, I was only popping in for a quick chat, it's not important.
OK.
You catch up when you sleep, eh? We can have a goss later.
So you're going to come back later, then?
Yeah, sure. See you after.
Lady Disfrelo.
Oh, I needed that.
God, she's blathered.
And I'm bored.
Well, what do you want to do then?
Can't we go to your room or something?
Yeah? Oh, sound.
Mum?
Kim?
Is it all right if me and Shadon go to my room and play a few tapes?
I don't mind if I do, love.
Go on then.
Ta.
Hey, hey. She'll eat you for breakfast.
That's the idea.
Oh. Hang on, love. I almost forgot. As you all know, young Timothy here came to my rescue on the number 10 bus the other day. And so it's with great pleasure I announce that I've nominated him for Maisie Mart Hero of the Week Award.
Oh, isn't that lovely?
Yes.
So, with a bit of luck, we'll see this lovely little face of his all over the newspapers. Oh, congratulations, love!
Yes.
Oh, my hero.
See, I told you that it'd be all right, didn't I?
Well, I'm supposed to be getting changed for work.
Relax, Max.
I wish I could.
You can.
You look nice. What's the,
I'm covering for you at the restaurant.
Since when?
Since I decided it might be fun to work front of house now and again.
Yeah, but,
Not like you to look a gift horse in the mouth.
Are you sure?
Well, I can either stay here and drive myself mad, thinking about Jackie Dixon and what might have been, or and start getting on with things.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, I think we should put this fiasco behind us.
Max, it wasn't a fiasco.
Sorry.
If you get bored while I'm earning a crust, then take a flick through these. I think we deserve a holiday.
Tim and Shadon are very quiet, aren't they?
They make a lovely couple.
I can see them strolling down the aisle now, him in his camo gear and in a trackie.
Love's young dream.
Oh, well, here's to them. He saved my life, that lad.
Yeah, here's to Tim.
And all who sail in him.
Is Susanna in?
No, no, why? What's the,
Well, you know that offer. Have you found anyone else?
We haven't even looked.
Oh, thank God for that. OK, I'll do it. But I need more money. 30,000 instead of 15.
We can't.
What do you mean? You can't?
Exactly what I say.
Well, I know it sounds a lot, but having a baby for someone, well, that's a hell of a thing to ask.
I'm sorry, you don't understand.
Don't tell me you can't afford it. You've got God knows how many grand's worth of cars stood in the drive for the kickoff. Your problem's not cash, it's finding the right girl, and here I am.
Why the sudden change of heart?
Well, does it matter as long as I'm up for it?
I'm sorry, but the situation's changed. Susanna and I, we've decided to forget the whole thing.
You are?
After you turned us down, we realised that we'd only be putting ourselves in the firing line for even more heartache, and we've had our quota for one lifetime.
Aren't you listening to me, Max? I'm saying yes.
And I'm saying no.
Well, you can't mess people around like this.
I can assure you that was never our intention.
But, Max, I need that money. I am banking on it.
I'm sorry, Jacqueline.
Oh, just forget it.
Brookside returns tomorrow and every day this week at 8:30. Next tonight, Equinox talks to some of Britain's top athletes about the mental processes they employ to achieve their maximum potential, where winning and losing can be all in the mind.